All right, everybody. I don't know if you can see the fire. I know you can see the antler. You can see the fire. Oh, you can barely see it. Right there. So we got some pretty good coals that are going to build up. I called my mom, and I think she's going to bring over some corn. So she can share her corn, and I'll share my pork loin with her. This is my truck get-home bag. I think you guys have seen it. It's a knockoff of the Expedition. I forget the name. It's a single sling, but it has two straps. One that goes around your shoulder, and then one that comes up under. See? And you can run with this. I've run with it, jumped with it, jogged with it, done everything with it. It's very thick material. It's got really thick zippers. I don't know if you can... I've done a review on this before. And it's got cinch straps on the sides. And a cinch strap over here in the front. And it's actually very heavy duty. I'm going to go through it real quick. Just to see if I got to update anything. I do have a 55-gallon drum liner in this concealed pocket in the back. And with that, we don't need to replace. I have a lightweight shemagh. I'm going to replace this. I have heavyweight shemaghs. I mean, these will do the trick. It's a light one. But get the heavyweight one, guys. The military ones. I have my 511 Mora. Water. It's been in here for quite a while. Doesn't taste too bad, but you know what? I think I better wash the bottles and replace the water. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. They're about 25 ounces, 27, if I'm not mistaken. So that's about 54 ounces of water. Have a couple of good gloves. So the stuff I'm gonna keep in the bag, it's gonna go here, and then what I wanna replace goes over here. These are glasses. They're sunglasses. Safety glasses, which is what I use most of the time because I got tired of buying Oakleys and those expensive ones, and I lose them or they get stolen, and just get these. If they can work to protect your eyes in a safety environment, construction site or whatever, they're good enough. Make sure that you're UV rated. So there's a knife, glasses, gloves. Here's a cap, very well ventilated cap. You can look, almost see through it. You can actually see through it. We'll let Mr. Antler hold it there. Here's the food. I know I'm gonna have to replace that right there. So there's another 55-gallon drum liner. Got plenty of those. There's a pocket in here with nothing in it. There's a zipper pocket up here. See, there's a pocket in here with nothing in it. It's got some Velcro. This is just a... Ooh, it's hot out here, guys. It's going to get to 98 or 99 degrees. It's a very thin scarf. Cotton scarf or... No, I don't know if it's cotton. But it's very thin. You can use it for... You have to put it under that cap. If it's... If too much sunlight is going in into my bald head through the cap, I can put this on there and it help me protect my neck, you know. This is a mosquito net that I can say is a cheap poncho. I almost said a bad word there. Not a bad word, but it's really hot out here, guys. This is tinder material. I don't think I would need that, but... Okay, now we're getting to the outside. Two pockets on the outside. Three. Two, three. The little one on top. And then it's got this cord up here. With one of these lock things on it. The gum? We'll take a chance and leave it in there. My headlamp. Oh, wow. I forgot this was in there. Well, it's still working. See? So that's good. The batteries haven't popped. Silk hot key or four-way key for this industrial faucets. A gonzo. Since this is a truck bag, guys. I mean, yeah, the bag was about $30. I'm not going to buy a $100 Maxpedition and keep it in my truck. I'm not going to use my $65, $75, $85 Gerbers or Leathermans. So, this is a cheaper Gerber. Forget what it's called. I thought it was a gonzo. It's a suspension, Gerber suspension. So maybe I will change this out for a gonzo. I don't know if I want to. Well, I mean, it's a good tool, so. If I do need it, yeah, I might as well have something reliable. Yeah, we'll leave that in there. And I have small. Whoa. Pepper spray. Here I have a very small boo-boo kit. Got blister aid, insect repellent. Got some aspirin and diarrhea. And a couple of plasters, you know, like band-aids. And that's it. I got an ace bandage. Don't ask me why. Smells like Vicks. Don't ask me why that's in there. I cannot remember. Got some Gold Bond. For this, good for chafing, for your feet, for morale. Throwing on your body. It's taking a while to get home. You want to smell good. This is that toilet paper. A subscriber told me to carry this instead of a roll of toilet paper. This is those you put a little bit of water and bam, they expand. So that stays. This stays. This says, oh wow. See, I got two headlamps. Why do I want two headlamps? I don't know. And I do not have a flashlight. I just noticed that, guys. I'm supposed to have a flashlight on here. Huh, I wonder where it went. See, it's good for you guys to go through your bags once in a while. See, I have a headlamp here. And this one's not quite as good as this one. This one's not great. I think this is like Energizer one. And it's not great, but it is better than the one I have in here. Flashlight, guys, a flashlight. That's what I'm wondering where it's at. I have emergency waterproof matches, some jute twine, a lighter, and that's all that's in there. That can stay. So, I got two energy, those 5-hour energy drinks. One's strawberry, one's grape, or berry and grape. So that stays. Yeah, you give me one of those and I'll run that roadrunner, that coyote. It's napkins. They can double to soak up blood, as toilet paper. This is a You Dig It knockoff tool and it has been used. You can still have dirt on it. That's about it. I'll bring out the scale. Let me go change these bottles out or wash them and rinse them and then I'll bring you back. Okay, guys, I haven't done what I said I was going to do yet, but I think I'm going to keep this ace bandage. I don't know. I think I am. If you want to comment on that, feel free. And we didn't go through the food bag, guys. I want you guys to see all my junk. This is an old MRE bag, and it's got pieces of an MRE in there. And I got some duct tape, because duct tape is good tape. Clean that dirt off of my outdoor kitchen table. There, these clip bars have been replaced, so these are good. This is not good, guys. I know, because I had one the other day. And it was compromised, so we're taking this out. This we don't know yet. We're taking that out. MRE food, that stuff never goes bad. This is all MRE. Got crackers, peanut butter, cheese spread, still pliable. Got another fruit bar. Pomegranate. It doesn't taste that good, but it gives you calories, energies. Some drink mixes, those we don't have to replace. Couple of wet wipes with the American flag. Yeah, I love that flag, because it's a good flag. This is a Bridgeford sandwich. We'll leave that in there. And here's a spoon, MRE spoon. Don't ask me why it's in there, but we'll leave it in there. Yeah, the food. Oh, here's some more stuff. That's why that spoon is in there. Spiced apples and beef enchilada in sauce. Got quite a bit of food. And you know, this food, you can eat it like that. I don't have a problem eating it like that. I don't have to have it warm. Some people do. But sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do, you know? And with no questions asked. So, we'll leave these, we said, in there. Got an airplane out here early in the morning. We have an airport that's like 10 miles from my house. It's a very small airport. And they actually teach you how to fly airplanes out there and license you and all that. It's a little airport. It's next to these huge railroad facility that got built out there. I think this is more than enough food, guys. I live 25 miles from where I work, so it'll take me between 20 to 30 miles to walk it, and it should be more than a day. And that's more than enough food. And with this, ooh yeah, I'll be running, baby. Be back. Okay, guys. I decided to keep the haze bandage. I put some safety pins in there. Because you can never go back wrong with these safety pins. They don't weigh anything, they don't take up any room. I did decide to keep my old, the cheap, lightweight Chamug. Because, I mean, like I said, this is, my Gerber tool is probably the most expensive thing I got in there. And that's as much as I want to risk. I did replace the bottles. This is a Sub-Zero and Sub-Zero, and I thought this was a Zig. I think this is a Zig bottle. No, it's a, you know what, they're both Sub-Zeros. But yeah, I filled them up, put a couple of drops of Clorox, filled them up with drinking water, filtered drinking water. And then I'm gonna get a weight, a scale, so I can weigh this up for you also. Okay guys, I'm gonna bore you. Oh, I did get this other little flashlight. This is a ridiculously bright flashlight, and I just got it out of eBay. Bought a couple of them, gave some to my sons. And so I'm gonna keep this and the headlamp, the little headlamp that's in here, in case I need to look for something through the back. This flashlight is ridiculously bright, and it has a long throw. So I'm gonna take this out also. It's bulkier, but it's not that heavy, but I don't think I'll need it. Anyways, I'm not afraid of the dark. Anyway, so let's see if we can put everything back. Water bottles to distribute the weight. The biggest, this is a food bag. It's in between the, oh my God, I don't know if you guys can see all that sweat, guys. It's getting really hot out here. Whew. Energy drink out in the front so we can grab one and slam one and hit 5 hours real quick. Or do the first 5 hours real fast, and we'll put the food powder there. This we can put right there also. Ace bandage we can put right there. Good music. Old music, old school music. Multi-tool. Can put it right there. toilet paper, gum, silk hot key we can put in this drawer. First aid, how about first aid? We put it back here, which is a little bit more protective. Pepper spray, cotton rag, or whatever kind of rag it is. Napkins, and this pouch right here. Put the trowel there, or the, and the mosquito thing, mosquito net. Glasses, gloves, the cap, and my knife. We'll put the flashlight, we'll put it in this pocket. Hopefully I won't forget it's there. Chumag. Cheap chumag. Can yank on these zippers, like yank on them like you wouldn't believe it. They got some nice zipper pulls. They never given me an indication that I should be more gentle with them, or that they're gonna give, and if they do, well, oh well. Buckle it all up. That's it. Let's get a weight for you guys in pounds. Water bottles are full. It keeps moving. Whoops, can you guys see it? So it's well under 12 and a half pounds. And right now, I don't know. Shoulder I have it for. I think it's my right shoulder. Yeah. See? And I can still tighten it up a little bit more. And I can go either way on either shoulder. Fantastic little bag. I love it. Thank you guys for watching. It's a hot one out here, man. I'm gonna cook. Maybe I'll bring you guys back for that. Stay safe, and thanks for all of your support.